Hey guys, it's your girl Afrini Kibiafo. I'm coming back at you guys today just to share with you guys what's on my shelf. You can expect in this series reviews from products that I've tried, introductions to products that I've purchased, and also my first impression on all the items in my Curl Kit boxes monthly. So today I have 5 products to review for you guys on my shelf. As you can see, this is my shelf. This is the little ensemble that I put together for all my hair products and stuff like that. So let me just jump right in. The first product that I'm going to be reviewing is the Shea Moisture Coconut and Hibiscus Curl and Shine Shampoo. You guys saw me using this shampoo in my last video when I showed you guys how I washed one section of my hair. And one thing that I have to say about the shampoo is the fact that when I applied it to my hair felt super stiff. And I've had this experience with plenty of shampoos in the past, so it's not something new. But at the same time, I didn't really like how stiff it made my hair because I wasn't able to comb through it once I put the shampoo in there. But nonetheless, it did make my hair clean, so it did cleanse my hair the way it should have. And I like the smell. I can say when I washed it out, my hair was pretty, you know, it was all right. I can't say it was like 100% soft, but washing it out, it was okay. It wasn't that bad of a shampoo. Will I repurchase it? I'm actually not sure, so I'm kind of happy that I bought the small size, because if I didn't like it, it would have not been too fun if I would have had a bigger bottle and spend all that money and ended up not liking the shampoo. I'll probably be keeping that on my shelf until I finish it up, and then once I finish it up, I will decide whether I will repurchase it again. The second thing that I'm going to review for you guys is the conditioner that I used in the video, and this was the all natural anti-shrinkage knot out conditioner, and it looks like this. This product I actually do really like. I really like this product a lot. First of all, what got me first was the smell. It says that it has mango oil and bamboo milk, and whatever is in this product, it smells super fruity. I'm really big on conditioners that have a lot of, like, have a really fruity smell. It just smells like a fruit bowl. Like, I mean, I know that sounds funny, but it really smells so good, and that's what caught me in the beginning. Also, what also caught me was the fact that I like that it has major slip. Like, it was so easy for me to comb through my hair. My hair was super soft. Once it was detangled and then washing it out, my hair was like baby soft. I will be keeping this conditioner on my shelf. I really don't have anything bad to say about it, so let's get into the next product. The next thing I'm going to be talking about is, you guys saw me applying this Shea Moisture's Deep Treatment Mask in the last video that I did, showing you guys washing my hair. And one thing I automatically didn't like right off the bat was the smell. I cannot stand the smell of this. I could smell the shea butter, the raw shea butter in there. It also says that it has sea kelp and argan oil, and I'm not sure if it's that that's throwing me off, but I really cannot stand the smell. Another thing is, you guys know that my favorite deep conditioner is La Care Cholesterol Plus. I know you guys have seen this about 1,000 times in my other videos. And so in my mind, I was really comparing how I felt about this treatment mask to my deep conditioning treatment, which is La Care Cholesterol Plus. And on that hand, this is a very, very milky, it has very milky consistency. My deep conditioner, La Care Cholesterol Plus, is really, 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 really thick. And so I'm used to being heavy-handed with my La Care Cholesterol Plus, and it was hard for me not to be heavy-handed with this. I kind of tried, and it was like a fail, because I was heavy-handed with this, thinking that I didn't have enough on each section. And then when I went to twist the section after I felt like I had enough, there was so much on my hands that I felt like I wasted the majority of it. So I guess I'm going to use this up, because I don't believe in having products around and not using them. So I'm going to use it up, but when I use it again, I will definitely be using a lot less. I learned that a little bit goes a long way with this product. So I didn't like the fact that I didn't like the way it smelled. I don't really care for the milky consistency, and it did make my hair not nearly as soft as the Care Cholesterol Plus does. So I mean, I guess I'm kind of like comparing all these deep conditioners that I'm going to be trying in the future. I'm going to be comparing them to my La Care Cholesterol Plus, because that is a staple. This will not be a staple of mine because I didn't like it that much, but I will be using it up, and I can't say it's a horrible product. I just don't really feel like it's something I'll be seeing on my shelf for that long after I use it up. So yeah, this probably won't be returning to my shelf, but that was my, you know, honest opinion about this deep treatment mask. So that's the third product. The next product I'm going to be talking to you guys about is this gel. It's completely done, y'all. This is the Hawaiian Silky Activator Gel. This is not the first time that I've used this gel, obviously, because it's done. So this is on my shelf because it's been on my shelf. And the reason why I'm reviewing this is because I don't think I've reviewed it in the past. But as you guys can see, I'm sporting a wash and go today. And so I use this gel alongside another product that I'm about to review in a second. This gel, I love this gel. I did, like, it didn't, her results didn't look like she had gel in her hair. And then also, it was very easy to apply to the hair, and then also, there was no flakes. Like, she had no flakes at all. So after she raved on and on about this, I thought I would try it, and I decided to do a wash and go a couple of months back. I think it was in April, and I fell in love. So that's why this is empty. There's not a drop left of it, so I'm reviewing this because this has become a staple gel of mine. I use this for the wash and go. I have my hair, and I got great results. No crunchiness, no flakes, no none of that stuff. So this is on my shelf, and it's going to continue to stay on my shelf. The last product that I have to review for you guys today is the Beautiful Textures Curl Defining Styling Custard, and this is awesome. First of all, I just said how much I like when hair products smell really fruity. This smells super fruity. I don't have any ideas of what it has in it that's making it smell that frizzy, because, I mean, that fruity, because I really didn't even look at the ingredients. But anyway, it's a curling custard, and I used it in my niece's hair a really long time ago, and we have two totally different textures of hair. She has that soft, baby, fine, curly type of texture, and it worked perfect for her curls and her hair, so I decided to try it along with the gel activator, and it worked perfectly. This is a very jelly consistency, like, as you can see. It's like super jelly, like really it looks like it's like jelly, like it smells so good. It smells so good. It smells like pineapples mixed in with some mango and some, like, I don't know, but it smells really good. And it worked really good in my hair. It was easy to apply to my hair. It's not super slippery, and it's also not super thick. It's like right in the middle, so it's like totally perfect. And I really feel like this is what gave me a lot of the definition that I have in this wash and go that I'm sporting right now. And so I'm definitely going to be keeping this on my shelf for as long as I do wash and goes. You know, you guys know I really don't do wash and goes like that. They've never really been my thing because I don't like short hair. Look how much shrinkage I have. Like, my hair is super big and super long. Like, if you look at the picture on my shirt, I took this picture a year and a half ago. This picture in the middle, I took this picture a year and a half ago. So imagine if I did this picture now, how big my hair would be. But look how small my hair is right now. I swear, shrinkage is the craziest thing. But I love that gel, both of those gels. I loved, everything that it, did for my hair. I know that a product that, I use for gel in my hair, I know that it works really, really good when my hair shrinks up. Like, the back of my hair is the longest part of my hair, and it usually doesn't shrink up, not nearly as the rest of my hair does. So I know a product works really well when the back of my hair shrinks up with the rest. But I decided to do a wash and go because I told you guys that I was going to be embracing my curls and my shrinkage for 1 week. So this is the first day of me doing that. At work, everybody was asking me, like, oh, did you cut your hair? And honestly, I didn't cut my hair at all. Like, this is just shrinkage, y'all, and it's really crazy. And I've never embraced it up until now, but I'm trying to do that right now. Like, I'm trying to embrace my curls and stuff like that, because it's not like I hate them. It's just, everybody has what works for them and what they like and stuff like that, and I like big hair. I don't really care for shrunken up hairstyles, but this is pretty much it. So that's it for what's on my shelf today. You guys will be seeing a lot more videos about what's on my shelf, like I mentioned earlier, the things that you can expect from this series. I thank you guys for watching my channel. I thank you guys for subscribing. I thank you for all the support that you give me. Check me out on Tumblr at @AfroNikiBeautiful. Check me out on blogspot.com at AfroNikiBeautifulChick.blogspot.com. All the links will be in the description box. Let me know in the comment section below how you guys embrace your curls, like whether that be twist outs, spray outs. How do you embrace your curls? How do you embrace your shrinkage, and what products do you use? Maybe you guys can give me some tips on what you do, and that can help me out and help me